So today we'll continue the integration of three standard formula. So look at here. Okay. Like six standard formula, we have three standard formula here. So first one is a square minus x square root of the dx. Okay. So this is x into integrand by 2. X into integrand by 2 plus a square by 2 sin inverse x by a. The first formula. Go to second formula. A square plus x square under square root. Same x into integrand by 2 plus a square by 2. So recall what was 1 by a square plus x square. This was in the log form. So that is log x plus root over of a square plus x square. Easy to remember. If you remember 1 by a square minus x square, this is sin inverse x by a, only this part is extra. Similarly, 1 by a square plus x square, this part, so this part is same. X into integrand by 2. So similarly, third formula is x square minus a square dx, x into integrand by 2 minus, when it is minus, here is minus a square by 2 log x plus root over of x square minus a square. Okay, let's see its application. How are you going to solve it? Suppose you get a question 3x square minus 9 under square root. Okay, so what will you do? It is root 3 x square minus 3 square. So which formula then? Root over of x square minus a square. What is the formula? That is x into integrand by 2 minus a square by 2 minus a square by 2 log x plus root over of x square minus a square. Okay. In place of x, now we have got root 3x. So what is that? At the last, chain rule, its derivative you have to divide. Otherwise, follow the formula here. So what is the formula? X into root over of x square minus square. What is x here? The root 3x. Root over of x square. Root 3x whole square minus 3 square minus a square by 2. 3 square by 2. Log x. X means root 3x. Plus root 3x square minus 3 square. Then plus a constant of integration. So if you simplify, what do you get? That is root 3x, one more detail. Divided by root 3x the derivative. That is root 3x, root over of 3x² - 9 - 9/2 log root 3x plus 3x² - 9 divided by root 3. Then cross the constraint. Okay. So if I take another question. This is 4 - x² √2. So write in the square form 2² - x² dx. That is, which formula you are relating? The a² - x². This is your related formula. What is the formula? X into integrand by 2 plus a² / 2 sine inverse x/a. So what is a here? 2, x is x. So you get, this is x√2² - x² / 2 minus minus plus 2² / 2 sine inverse x/2 plus constant. These two is cancelled. So you can write x√4 - x² / 2 plus 2 sine inverse x/2 plus constant. Okay. See a question here. If you get a question like this, x² + 2x√2. What you will do in this case? Because your three standard formula is x² a² means no x, a² x², no x term, x² a². So you are getting a term 2x. So already I have taught you, you have to use the completing the square. So completing the square already I have taught you. That is x² 2 into 1 into x 2ab plus 1² - 1² dx. Then it will be x + 1² - 1² related formula is now x² - a². So related formula is x² - a² √dx. What is that? X into integrand by 2 plus, not plus, if it is minus then it will be minus, a² / 2, formula should be clear and it should be correct also. So now what is x in place of x? You have got x + 1 √x + 1² - 1² / 2 minus a² / 2. a² means 1² / 2 log, I can write that one here, log x, x means x + 1 plus √x + 1² - 1² Achha, don't forget to divide the derivative of x + 1. What is derivative of x + 1? Is 1. So no need to divide, but if you get sum of the number, you have to divide. So conclusion is x + 1. This is simplified. The question means x² + 2x. Because if you go back to the steps, this consider your question. Minus 1 by 2 log x plus 1 plus root over of x square plus 2x plus constant. But if you get a question x square plus 1, 2x plus 1 root over of x square plus 2x plus 5, x square plus x plus 5. What do you do in this case? Now you have to create the derivative. It's got derivative. Similar question already I have told you. You have created its derivative. Derivative is how much? 2x plus 1, which is already here. So that is how much? If its derivative is present here, that means it is like f dash x fx to the power n dx is fx to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1, because exactly its derivative become 5 per derivative 0. 2x plus 1, 2x plus 1. This is your f dash x. This is fx to the power n. So how much you will get in this? So that will be fx to the power n plus 1, x square plus x plus 5 to the power half plus 1 by half plus 1 plus a constant. So 3 by 2 will be 2 by 3. Power is 3 by 2, then plus a constant. Okay, this is one pattern. Another pattern is when its derivative is not here. What you do in that case? Like, suppose you get a question x plus 2 root over of x square minus 4x plus 3. It is a problem. Because its derivative is 2x minus 4. This is 0. So here is x plus 2, not 2x minus 4. So I have create here 2x minus 4. First you have to create 2x. How to make 2x? I have to multiply half n 2. Like this. Okay, what I did? Because I need 2x, so I have multiplied 2 means I have divided 2. So this became how much? So that is half 2x plus 4. But what you need? You need 2x minus 4, but you are getting 2x plus 4. So what you have to do? You have to make it minus 4 plus 4. This became 2x plus 4, but you need 2x minus 4. So I made it minus 4 plus 4. You will combine these two together. And root over of x square minus 4x plus 3 dx. So now if you do the arrangement, 2x minus 4, one group. This two, one group with this number. X square minus 4x plus 3 dx. Other part is this 4 and 4 will be 8. X square minus 4x plus 3 dx. Okay. This the became f dash x fx to the power 8. So that became, so half 2x minus 4. This is, you use here f dash x fx to the power n. What is the formula? Now fx to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So it will be half What is your fx? This one, x square minus 4x plus 3 power is half plus 1 by half plus 1. Means this part is over. This part has no x. You do it by completing the square. So that will be plus integration of 8 into root over of x square minus 2 into 2 into x. 4x, 2ab, so plus 2 square minus 2 square minus 3 dx. Completing the square, x square minus 4x is 2ab, so b is 2, plus 2 square minus 2 square, then that plus 3, sorry, plus 3 is here, plus 3. So you get this is half, this is 3 by 2 will be 2 by 3, power is 3 by 2, plus 8 times, this is x plus x minus 2 whole square, this is minus 4 plus 1 is minus 1 square. Which related formula is here? And that is x square minus a square root over x into integrand by 2 plus a square by 2 log x plus root over of x square minus a square. So half into 2 by 3, x square minus 4x plus 3, 3 by 2, plus 1 by 2 into 8. Formula is x into this, what is x? X minus 2. Of x minus 2 whole square minus 1 square by 2 plus, sorry, not plus, it is minus, it will be minus here. The minus 1 square by 2 log x minus 2, let me write down here, minus 1 square by 2 log x minus 2 plus root over of x minus 2 whole square minus 1 square. Okay. The final line you can write. This is 4. This is cancel. 1 upon 3 x square minus 4x plus 3 power is 3 by 2. Second part plus 4 x minus 2 into, this is simplified as what? X square minus 4x plus 3. Okay? By 2. Then minus 1 by 2 log x minus 2 plus root over of x square minus 4x plus 3. So like this, there are few questions. Where you find this type of question? That is in the last page of your textbook. You open it, last page. So you'll find this kind of question, try to solve. Now today we'll enter the very important part, that is integration by parts. Integration by parts. means you call as product truth.
So there should be two functions to evaluate,
that is UVDX.
UVDX.
So from these two you have to choose, one is first function, other is second. So if there are two functions, you have to choose one is the first function, other is the second. So what is the formula? The first integration of second dx. First function integration of second minus integration of differential coefficient of first. Integration of second whole dx. Means here we have to do two times integration. So looks, because you will habitually go on solving few questions on this. See a question, which one to know, which one is first function, which one is second function, what is the clue on that? So write down, to select the first function, to select the first function will follow ILET. ILET will follow. I stands for inverse. This is logarithmic functions. This is algebraic functions. This is trigonometric functions. This is exponential functions. So this table you have to remember. Whichever comes first, that will be your first function. Okay, let me try how to use this. I have few questions on this. Suppose you get a question, x sin x. See carefully. There are two functions. One is x, one is sin x. X will be called as algebraic function. Sin x will be called as trigonometric functions. So you see the sequence, first is your algebraic function, then trigonometric function. That means this will be your first function, this will be your second function if you compare these two. So algebraic function x, trigonometric function sin x, that means this is your first function.
So selection of first function is over,
then you go to find out what is the rule. Now first function, integration of second, minus integration of derivative of first, integration of second whole dx. This is the formula. Okay, look at here. First function means x, integration of sin x, first integration of second, then minus integration of derivative of first. So ddx of x, then integration of second, second means which one, sin x whole dx. So you have to simplify, x sin x ka integration is minus cos x, minus integration of derivative of x is 1, sin x ka minus cos x. So again you have to integrate this. What is that? 1 into minus, minus minus will be plus. What is left out? Only cos x. So cos x ka integration will be sin x. So it is minus x cos x, minus minus plus cos x ka integration is sin x plus a constant. Okay, now I will take a question, x square plus 1 log x, what to do? Algebraic function, logarithmic functions. So look here, log is first, then algebraic function. That means this is your first function. So rule is same. First function, integration of second minus integration of derivative of first into integration of second. So if I follow this step, same thing, look at here. First means log x. Integration of second. Second means x square plus 1 dx. Minus integration of derivative of first. Derivative of first means derivative of log x. Into integration of x square plus 1 dx. Okay. So, to simplify this, it is log x, x square ka integration. Now you should write directly x cube by p, 1 dx plus x, this part is over, minus integration of log x ka derivative 1 by x, phir x cube by p plus x dx. X square is x cube by 3. 1 का dx. Now you multiply this. What do you get? It is log x, x cube by 3 plus x. So when I multiply this, x will be cancelled. So 1 by 3 x square dx plus 1 by x into x is 1 dx. So you have to integrate it again. What do you get? Log x, x cube by 3 plus x minus x cube by 3. 1 by 3 is here. 1 by 9. Can I hear 1 by 9? 3 into 3. Then 1 dx is x. Second pattern. See another question on this. Suppose I get a question. Only log x. A short question every time. There is no formula directly integration of log x, and we need two functions for this product rule, and you are finding only one. So you can write 1 into log x. Then what will be called 1? What will be called log x? 1 will be called as algebraic function. Log x. This log is there. This is algebraic function. Then logarithmic function. Log comes first. When this is your first. So recall the formula. First function. Now you should write directly integration of second minus integration of derivative of first integration of second. Dx. So log x into 1 dx is x minus it is 1 by x log x derivative 1 by x 1 by then x. This is cancelled. So only 1 dx left out. So log x into x minus 1 dx is x plus x. Okay, let's take another question. What about x square e to the power x dx? Obviously, e to the power x is the last exponential function, so this will be your first function. So, x square is a first function, algebraic function, e to the power x the exponential function. The rule is, once you select the first function integration of second minus integration of derivative of first integration of second. So x square e to the power x. What is the x square derivative? 2x e to the power x. Still there are two functions, but the power is reduced. That means if you integrate one more time, this will be vanished. So you are getting x square e to the power x minus 2. Again you have to select, this is your first function. First function integration of second minus integration of 2 I have kept outside because constant. Derivative of first integration of second whole dx. So conclusion is x square e to the power x minus 2. This is e to the power x is e to the power x. X e to the power x. Derivative of x is 1 e to the power x. Okay. So only 1 is left out, e to the power x. So e to the power x ka integration is e to the power x. So x square e to the power x minus 2x e to the power x minus minus plus e to the power x is e to the power x. Okay, these are the questions which you did about the functions. So far you have not used this word, inverse. So I have kept it the last because these are the special questions based on this inverse function. Let's start from a simple function. So that is how to integrate suppose only one sine, only sine inverse x. So obviously when it is only sine inverse x, you have to write 1 into sine inverse x. Then comes the rule of I late. Inverse comes first. So this is your first function then. So the rule is, first function integration of second minus integration of derivative of first integration of second. Hold dx. So sine inverse x into x. Okay. What is derivative of sine inverse x? That is 1 by 1 minus x square. Then into x dx. Because 1 condition is x. So now how to integrate this? You can get a clue here. Its derivative is minus 2x. This minus I can take inside, this can be minus. That means only you need 2. If you multiply 2 here, then this will be related to your f dash x by f x to the power n, the formula. Then I told you about this. So create the derivative. How to create derivative? Now half n to minus will be inside because its derivative is minus 2x. So sine inverse x into x plus half. Plus means minus I have taken inside. So it becomes minus 2x. Now you have created your derivative. So what will happen here? Its derivative is this means which formula? So x sin inverse x plus half. You can use here f dash x by f x to the power n. Is f x to the power minus n plus 1 by minus n plus 1. This formula. So that will be x sin inverse x plus half 1 minus x square power is minus half plus 1 minus half plus 1 plus x square. So the conclusion is x sin inverse x plus 1 by 2. This is 1 minus x square root over what? Now 1 minus half is half. This is also half. But this gets cancelled. Plus a constant. Okay? So you will try this question. Cos inverse x. Go to practice some questions now. It's similar to this one. Now let me take what about tan inverse x. So question is only tan inverse x. So if you go to island, inverse is first. So that will be 1 into tan inverse x. This is your first inverse. Apply the rule. What do you get? So first function, integration of second, integration of derivative of first. Integration of second. This is tan inverse x into x minus, this is 1 by 1 plus x square. Derivative you have to recall, all the derivative will be used here. Then multiplied by x dx. Now you check what is its derivative. 2x, 1 to 0, x square 2x, only x. That means half into 2. Tan inverse x into x minus half 2x by 1 plus x square. Remember there is no power here. This is f dash x by fx. So the formula is f dash x by fx log fx. So x tan inverse x minus half log of fx means denominator. Remember there is no nth formula here because the power is 1, f dash x by fx. So some difficult questions we will be discussing tomorrow. Today you try to solve some more questions on this.